फ्रेंड्स, आई एम भास्कर। टुडे वी विल रिवाइज द प्रोनाउन। व्हाट इज प्रोनाउन? अ प्रोनाउन इज अ वर्ड विच इज यूज्ड इन प्लेस ऑफ अ नाउन। यूसेज ऑफ नाउन रिपीटली स्पॉइल्स द ब्यूटी ऑफ अ सेंटेंस एंड मेक्स इट अंडरस्टैंडिंग। द यूसेज ऑफ अ प्रोनाउन एड्स ब्यूटी टू अ sentence. Look at the example given below. Radha and Rama are best friends. Radha and Rama often spotted together. Radha and Rama enjoy spending time with each other. The repetition of noun Radha and Rama is making the sentence uninteresting. But if we use pronouns in the place of nouns, the sentence written above will look impressive and beautiful. Let's see how. Kinds of pronoun. There are 8 kinds of pronoun: personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, reflexive pronoun, emphasizing pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, indefinite pronoun, interrogative pronoun, relative pronoun. Personal pronoun. A personal pronoun is a pronoun that refers to a person, place, animal or thing. Read the following sentence. The highlighted words are personal pronouns. I am feeling hungry. I in the personal pronoun. Can you give me a glass of milk? You and me is a personal pronoun. Personal pronoun are 3 persons: first person, second person, third person. The first person is the person who is speaking. The second person is the who is being spoken to. The third person is the person who is spoken about. Singular, first person, I, me. Second person, you. Third person, he, she, it, him, her, it. Next, possessive pronoun. What is possessive pronoun? A pronoun that show possession is called possessive pronoun. These pronouns show that certain things belong to somebody. For example, mine, hers, his, yours, ours, theirs, etc. We tend to confuse possessive pronoun or possessive adjectives when used in the sentence. Possessive adjective and possessive adjective pronouns convey the same meaning, but possessive adjectives are used before nouns which they are describing, while possessive pronouns are used after nouns that they refer to. Look at the following sentence to understand the difference between the two. The book is mine. Her mine is a possessive pronoun. This is book my, by my book. Here my is a possessive adjective. This bottle is yours. Here yours is a possessive pronoun. This is your bottle. Here you is a possessive adjective. This house is ours. Here ours is a possessive pronoun. Next, what is a reflexive pronoun? Pronouns like myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, and themselves are called reflexive pronoun. These pronouns reflect that the action of the subject refers back to the subject. Itself, reflexive pronouns are always used an object of a sentence and never as a subject. Read the following sentences. The highlighted words are reflexive pronouns. I made this painting myself. Myself is the object and I is used as a subject. He enjoyed himself at the party. Himself is the object and he is the subject. They built the house themselves. Themselves is the object and they is the subject. She hurt herself while playing. Herself is the object and she is the subject. Next, emphatic pronoun. Pronouns like myself, yourself, himself and herself. When put right after pronouns that they are emphatic pronoun are called emphatic pronouns. Read the following sentence. The highlighted words are emphatic pronoun. I myself took this decision. She herself wanted to go. Next, demonstrative pronoun. A demonstrative pronoun is used to point out the thing or things which it refers to. This, that, these and those are called used demonstrative pronouns. Pronouns this and that are used for singular. These things, while these and those are used for plural things. This and these are pronouns which refer to things that are placed near the speaker, and that and those refer to things that are placed far from the speaker. Read from the following sentences. The highlighted words are demonstrative pronouns. This is a beautiful painting. That is a fierce dog. These are my best friends. Those are my schoolmates. Next, indefinite pronoun. The pronoun which do not refer to anybody in particular are called indefinite pronouns. For example, several, all, someone, everyone, few, etc. Read the following sentences. The highlighted words are indefinite pronouns. Several of his plans have been successful. All of his friends are really helpful. Someone or something are indefinite pronouns used for people or things. For example, someone broke the window pane. Her someone refers to any person in general and not a specific person. This is something very mysterious. Her something refers to a thing in general and not a specific thing. Indefinite pronouns like anybody, anything, anyone are used in negative or interrogative sentences. For example, I can't see anybody in the houses. Has anyone seen my spatulas? Someone, the pronouns anyone, anybody and anything used for in the positive sentences. For example, anyone can do this. Anything can happen. No one, nobody and nothing are called indefinite pronouns like no one has the right to say so. Nothing can be done about his now. Next, interrogative. The pronouns who, whom, whose, what and which are interrogative pronouns. They help in asking questions. We use the pronouns whose, who, whom and whose to ask questions about people. For example, who are you talking about? Whom did you meet in the market? We use pronoun what to ask questions related to things. For example, what is the price of this book? We use the pronoun which to ask questions about people or things. For example, which is your favorite color? Last is relative pronoun. A relative pronoun is a pronoun which is used to connect a clause or a phrase parts to a noun or a pronoun. It is called relative pronoun because it relates or refers to a noun or pronoun mentioned before. Relative pronouns who and whom are used for people. For example, the man who organized the party in my uncle. The boy whom you met yesterday in my cousin. The pronoun whose is used to refer to both people and non-living things. For example, the boy whose father is a doctor lives next door. The car whose headlight was broken was mine. The relative pronoun which is used for non-living things and animals. For example, the study table which you bought for me is really nice. The deer which hurt its leg was taken to the veterinary. The relative pronoun that is mostly used for non-living things. For example, this is a palace that King Mahendra built. This is a building that caught fire yesterday. Thanks.